Yo, what's up, everybody? I've got some bad news. Unfortunately, this year's spiel did not make it. Like, halfway through the editing process, the software completely crashed. We lost everything. Yeah, I'm pretty upset about it, too. But best I can do is a quick montage of all the previous year's spiels. So, without further ado, enjoy.
Spill the milk on the kitchen floor.
Not me, not me.
Who took a pen and wrote on the wall?
No, it was not me.
Who left a mess with all these toys?
Not me, it wasn't me.
And who is making...
Yo, you thought I was serious? Nah, bro. Welcome to Spiel 2023. Let's go!
News and the firmest Jews. We're live from the comic base vendors. I'm your host Benny.
And I'm your host Benny, and it's a pleasure having you today on the Benny and Benny Show. No, Benny,
I was thinking I was.
And you and your talent in being a host producer, one day you're going to have to teach me, but on a side note, I was actually at a. Can I please grab a quick refill of you over here? Thank you. But I was thinking, earlier tonight I was at a...
You know what, Bennett, we're going to get right to that. We have a lot of ground to cover tonight.
That's
right. Lots of special guests. We're going to have DJ straight from Camp Romo coming off a performance. And we're going to have a professional poker player with us tonight. So we'll get right to it, if you don't mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, tune in to all the festivities of tonight, because from the sounds of it, we have quite a lot. In fact, Benny, I was wondering, what's the weather like tomorrow?
You know, we'll get right to that, if you don't mind. And please relax. Stay tuned.
In fact, I do apologize for your arm injury. I didn't mean to pull out the chainsaw at the time that I did.
But we'll get right to that, won't we, Benny? It's good to have you back.
Yes, we'll get right to that. And on a side note, I was thinking that actually maybe we should... Give me a second.
Roll the ads, please. Stay tuned.
Yes, and
been interrupted to be a shearer and not understand a single word he's saying? Well, that used to be me. That was until I heard about the All-American Red Sea translation machine. I used to be one of those buckram that did not understand a single word Red Sea shearer.
Means is a euphemism, and then artificially it just eliminates which legal claim is he putting forward. Connotation is self-incriminating. And is not going to qualify as admittance. Sanguine, that's definitive evidence.
Because this All-American Red Sea translation sheet, I understand every word he says in this sheet. Skills. Bro! Oh! That's what he meant to share. Get your translation sheet today for only $29.99. If you get in the vending machine, it's $5 off. Bro. I'm getting this, bro.
Bro. Available as you have your kind of video. Really, it's each of the goof.
Bro. I'm getting it, bro.
Thank you. Do you feel like you're not a part of their school? Do you want to be? Well, you're in luck. We've got the perfect solution for you. Members wore new blue hoodies. Actually, scratch that. They're burgundy now. Don't like burgundy? Try green. Don't like green? How about white? Is white good for you? Don't like white? Scratch that. We got a black coat. A black coat? Don't like a black coat? How about a shoe? You want a shoe? No, you want a tutu. We got a new tutu for members more, guys. Actually, scratch that. It's just back to old good old gray. That's what we want. Good old gray sweater. And the best part is, it's just in time for the new season so that you can be warm and cozy outside just we like the way we like it. Ah! Oh my gosh, it's so hot outside!
We're at your own risk. Terms and conditions apply at MetroShmoeHoodies.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the MSTV show. I'm Benny, and this is my co-host, Benny. And we have a very special guest with us tonight. His name is 770. He is a professional poker player, is my understanding.
You know what, in fact, I think that 770 specializes in the casino called the Casino Caddis, short for casino. It's a bit of a oikimto within the word casino. But I was thinking that it's about time we get him on the show, so ladies and gentlemen, please welcome onto the show our dear friend and guest, 770.
Welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for coming.
Great to see you guys over here in Gahana, back in the casino over here in Israel.
You know what, 770? Back in my day, I was a bit of a professional poker player myself, so I would like to ask you, what are your favorite techniques, and what are you doing here on the show when you could be in Vegas making $2 million?
I'll be honest with you, I don't have any techniques regarding playing poker. All I do is I just go and try to make as much money as I can, and I cheat a lot in poker, and I make a lot of money, and I don't want to be here right now. I could be in Vegas making millions of dollars, be in Los Angeles, be all over the world. And for me to be here, it's a crazy thing.
You know what, 770, I want to hear a little bit about your technique.
There's no technique, I steal all my money.
You know, your strategy actually sounds quite interesting. It sounds very similar to Major Shmuel Bucher.
Hi, how are things getting along?
Yes, things are getting along quite fine, thank you.
I'm on the phone.
Oh, I do apologize, but you know,
no, I have no pay. No, I'll be honest with you. I don't want to be here.
Please amputate your phone.
Put it down.
But, hello? Yes, yes, it's a pleasure having you on the show. We're going to have to catch you next time. We're just here with 00. 770, turns out.
I might have to get out of here. I gotta go. I'm in a rush. I have people to see. I have a private jet taking off from Ben Gurion Airport right now.
Okay.
I'm going. I'm going now. I'll see you. Have a great day. Good night.
So you head for the stairs. Go to. It was nice to see ya. Yeah. Out of your dear. For once.
Whoa.
Go to. I understand. You've got some plans. Downstairs. Nearly, what's that, 32 years? But I've been dreaming to get out of the here. It's always the same. The bathroom, they get their way up and ground. I think that it's time I gotta vacate. Nice to see ya.
He really did enjoy seeing you.
I'm back to my dealer.
Back to his dealer, yes.
For once.
Yeah, he's really not there much.
Gold Duke, please understand.
Well, see, you gotta understand.
I got some plans.
And when you made some plans, you just gotta attend to
downstairs.
Just how it is.
Yeah, I believe that it's the time for me to finally align. Now I will book myself a flight and fly around up in the sky. I'ma hop over to Venice, gonna play some good old tennis. Go to LA where the sun is, and I'll practice my calzadas. For the students who want schmoozes, I'm not zooming, I'll be cruising. I'll be doing 102 in my old Buick, drinking root beer. I'll be thinking up and ringing up my friends for some amusement. I was dreaming, now I'm leaving, and that's the simple truth. Go, go, go.
Well, folks, it's unfortunate, but it seems that my longtime friend and co-host has decided to take a break for a little while. But have no fear, because we have a great audience with us here tonight. I'm sure we'll be able to find someone to replace him. Does anybody volunteer? Yes. What's your name, sir?
Dave Brock.
Dave Brock. Is that very nice to meet you. Have a seat.
Thank you very much. Very nice to meet you.
Well, welcome to the Brock and Binny Show. Well, that doesn't sound right, does it? Welcome to the Binny and Brock Show. So, Dave, tell me a little bit about yourself.
I wouldn't call myself a strict censor, a host, but even though I've been accused of host desecration a few times now, but I've had a sort of experience with interviewing people and I've wanted to educate, and it reminds me, I was once back in England and there was this very fancy, actually very fancy party and sort of what do you call it, a banquet, I think. And very funny looking person with this massive nose. Kind of look like a pickle, I have to say. But I told him, can I have a bite? I told him. Yeah, so that it was Tony Blair. Weird times.
Well, folks, this should be fun, shouldn't it? Let's have our first guest, shall we? We have a DJ tonight. His name is DJ Leash.
A musician.
A DJ, yes, and he'll be joining us shortly. Please stay tuned. Roll the ads.
Hey guys, it's me. Have you guys ever felt uncomfortable during the third hour of cheer? Have you ever just wanted to clock the guy next to you for snacking a little too loud? Have you ever wanted to get that body, that physique that you so dearly wanted? Introducing the MPG, the Midrash Pillow Gamak. Structure, there. Comfort, there. Clowniness, there! Now you're always prepared to clap the guy next to you for being snacked a little too loud, and you're always prepared. That's it. Bring your own pillowcase. Results may vary. Terms and conditions may apply.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Let me tell you about this fantastic piece of real estate that's just come onto the market. It's a beautiful state-of-the-art gym. Let me show you around. The time is bene storim. It's gonna be great.
This always happens, don't worry. So, you know, this is probably packed and stuff. It's open, it's definitely.
We're back. It's during Seder right now, so I don't have so much hope for this, but we're gonna check if it's open.
No surprise. Let me show you the tour.
Over here, we have two treadmills, two. In case the other one isn't working. In this case, this one isn't working, so we got this one.
This one isn't working as well, so we got this one.
They actually work better when they're broken. This gym acts as a multi-purpose room. We also have a fully functioning library. We have many, many different types of art scroll editions. Maseches Sanhedrin, over here. We have about 770 of them. We have our Sephardi Sfarim. We keep them in the corner. In this room, we have boxes of books. Don't mind the mold, it's not mold. Moving on to where the real action takes place. This is where the magic happens. We have a waiter over here. We like to spread them out. Make them quite hard to get to because that's where you grow. When you struggle, you grow. Now, let me tell you about safety's key, okay? Let me bring you into my favorite room over here. Sorry it's so messy, I was actually sleeping here last night.
My bad.
This is where people build muscles, big muscles. We have our hand sanitizer here, guaranteed 99.99713 that germs will be obliterated from your hand. These shards over here, they're actually pieces of the Medrash mirror, hung in the base of Medrash. Wow, wow. We have a 360 state-of-the-art AC fan unit. I just want to show you guys a couple of my favorite workout routines. This is called the Friday night routine.
Ooh!
You really feel it, in the nefesh, you feel it in the nefesh. This is the Al-Khayt Fliss. A couple things you should know about this absolutely fantastic gym is it actually comes with some professional bodybuilders. I mean, the weights they're lifting.
Come on! Come on! Come on! Up! I'm with you! Up! One more! Let's go! Come on! Push! You're nothing! Let's go! Come on! Push!
Push clean, do it well, don't. Your elbows, come on, push! Come on! Come on!
Help me, one more!
Come on, you got it! Come on! Do it!
When I came to Yeshiva, I was just pressured to go to the base 24/7. I couldn't do it, so I went to the gym. Now, 3 years later, do I go to Seder? Nah. But am I jacked?
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming on the tour with me. If you want to sign up, it's only 70 shekel a month. There's a slight yeshiva bocha deal. If you just don't tell anyone, it's actually free.
Good evening and welcome back to MSTV, where we have the fastest news and from his shoes. I'm your host, Penny. This is my co-host, Dave. How are you doing today, Dave?
Excellent. Very excited, I have to say. How do we have a musician coming on the show?
Actually, he's a DJ. It's not quite the same. I think we should just welcome him right on. He's here with us. He's backstage. He's actually right over there.
You mean he's right there?
Over there. Some may call this 6 o'clock. I call it 3 o'clock.
It's very timely.
Come on, DJ.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being with us.
I'm actually really excited to be here. You know, when my agent called me and told me I'm coming to the show, I got super excited because yeah, I've been watching you guys for years. I've been watching you for years.
So this is Dave. He's actually replacing my previous co-host Benny. Took a short leave, so Dave is a temporary replacement.
Temporary. I think I would prefer to see just.
So Dave, as we spoke about before, not everything has to be a legal analysis. So DJ, please tell me a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, of course. So actually, I go by DJ Jägermeister. I've been loving music ever since I was a toddler, ever since I was a little kid. I really, you know, got into music and I, you know, try to make and
I'm
produce.
I'm just confused. Yeah. When you say music, do you intend like proper idiosyncratic type of music like Beethoven, which is like long sounds that just never stops?
Yeah, so.
I'm just confused.
That's good. I like this guy more. So I get a lot of inspiration from Beethoven, from Bach.
You know, it's funny you mentioned Bach because my previous co-host Benny actually grew up with him in Golders Green.
Really? Yeah. Actually, I heard that. Yeah. He was Bach's babysitter for a while.
Correct. Yes.
Yeah, I heard about that. Yeah. So like you say, I listen to Beethoven, I listen to Bach, and I get a lot of inspiration from them, and then I go and do like the complete opposite. And
if I listen correctly, you're taking good music and turning it into nothingness.
Well, it's I mean, some people call it that. It's just,
this is not quite how we treat our guests around here. I know you're still learning on the job, but that's okay. DJ, I want to hear from you. Where do you get your creativity from?
So actually, that's a great question. My creativity is actually very interesting. I like listening to the general hum of the world. I like listening to like annoying sounds that people catch on to. You know, annoying sounds like, you know, his voice, like babies, children, whistling, snapping. But generally, like I like listening to, there's like these songs that play in the middle of my classes, these super annoying noises. And that's really, you know, my highlight of my class. So that's really where I get inspiration from.
I think what you're saying is very interesting, because it shows the audience. I think it's not so passionate at all to do music.
Yeah.
And I think you showed very well,
Family Nevin.
And actually, I think that you're a very interesting guest. I think in terms of intelligence, he's got a very nice bone structure.
Mm.
And I think in terms of musical talent, the boy knows how to make noise.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
It takes a lot of intelligence to be a DJ. Yeah.
So DJ, do you have any latest songs that you'd like to share with the audience?
Well, I'm actually super excited that you're asking that. So this next week, I have a song dropping. I'm actually super excited about it.
Amazing.
It's gonna be in all music platforms. You can all hear it from wherever you are. Yeah, I'm super excited about that.
What's the name of the song?
It's actually called file mp3.4.
Interesting. What do you think? Should we play it for the crowd?
Do you guys want to hear it? You guys want to hear your school bell rings?
I think they do.
Alright, let's play it. Let's play it.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. That was such a pleasure to have DJ Leash with us here.
What did you think about that song? That was incredible, wasn't it?
It was, I can't deny it. Something happened. Yeah, that's for sure.
It was truly incredible.
It was truly something. Yeah, it happened in front of our eyes, and what can I say?
Just a second, I'm getting breaking news. Yeah, breaking news, straight from live from, where are you, Bookie? The corner of KKL and Osishki. Yes, yes, that's the one with the traffic light that takes 15 minutes to cross. Yeah, yeah, that one, okay, fine. Yeah, what's going on over there? Yeah, we'll just send it right over to you.
Thank you very much. We're here at Midrashmot and Medic College Institute of Law Learning with Habakkuk Gaon, this guy, and we've just discovered that $2 million have been stolen. What do you have to say about this?
$2 million, huh? That's a lot of money. I didn't even know that. I didn't even know that much was gone.
What does this $2 million mean to you?
Be honest, absolutely nothing. It was just a great time. It took a long time, you know, the 48 hours, I believe it was, 72, I don't remember. But it was pretty intense.
That's a long time to be collecting money. Were you up this entire time?
Up physically, yeah. Mentally, no. Mentally, definitely not there. The amount that you gotta drink to ask for people money, wow. I can't even begin to explain it to you. It's like Yeshiva Walker on steroids.
Well, that was very interesting. Thank you very much, this guy. Back to you, MSTV.
Well, that was very unfortunate news to hear. What do you think, Dave?
I'm speechless, I have to say. Again, I might be wrong, but simply speaking, this is theft.
Mm.
Yeah. Grand theft.
This is truly terrible.
I thought I had encountered what pure evil was. Entering the Hanhala, turns out that was only the tip of the iceberg.
Well, this is truly terrible. This is also
my iceberg. Actually, back in England, his great uncle, he's a very solid person. He is the one actually who did the Titanic thing. Very impressive.
This is actually my good friend Benny. I don't know if you know. And this is his yeshiva. This is truly terrible news.
Very clever boy. Very special. He's got a mind of his own. And I think we've all seen that he's got a big cup and he's not prepared to dilute it.
Mm. That's very interesting. This is also my good friend Benny and his yeshiva, which is truly terrible to hear. And we still don't know where Benny disappeared to.
Maybe we should video call him. Why not?
You know what, Dave? That's an excellent idea. We should call him right now.
I'm full of that. That's nice picture.
Thank you.
How's my hair?
I think it's very good. I think it's actually gorgeous. Thank you very much. And also, very impressive how you did it. All the height, everything. Very, very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah. How's mine?
Pretty much non-existent.
Well, I think that's rude, but whatever. It's okay. I might be wrong, but it looks like he's not picking it up.
So what do you think? What should we do? Maybe we should ask, the audience? Maybe the audience, anybody in the audience have any idea where Benny might be?
Guys, you would not believe this. My favorite TikToker, aka Benny, just posted.
Marai Verabosai, it's Chaim Hila Machazikim Bur. Here are the trees. Let me show you some life.
You know, it's me
been a while since I've been traveling, but it's good to be back.
Well, what an interesting plot twist that was. Huh, Dave? What do you think?
Yeah, very much so. Quite unexpected, I think.
Very much so. Okay, guys, that was it for today. Thank you for joining us on MSTV, where we have the fastest news and the firmest Jews. Don't forget, tomorrow morning, the newest minion in North Korea, starting at 11 a.m. Yes, you heard it right, 11 a.m. And we'll be back with more tomorrow. Stay tuned.
Wait, guys, for my TikTok video, what are the chances of United Korea?
Don't. I wouldn't know. That's a no for me.
Could you be wrong?
I don't like this. I don't like this at all. And I think it's very rude of you to come right here. I don't like it. I think you should just leave right now.
Could you be wrong?
You know what, Dave? This is going to be quite an interesting show with you, isn't it?
I think so, too. I'm very interested.
I'm looking forward.
I'm not dull. That's for sure.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for joining us tonight on MSTV. Stay tuned.
My tardiness has got the better of me. You know, it was, thank God, a fantastic trip. It was definitely $2 million well spent. But I just have to figure out how to make it back. Maybe the casino outside in a couple hours could help me with that matter.